بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. أما بعد, this is our fifth lesson going through النحو الصغير authored by Sheikh Suleiman العيوني وفقه الله. We are still in the first part of علم النحو, where we are discussing أحكام الكلمة. We said that the أحكام الكلمة, there are three topics to be discussed. The first topic is نوع الكلمة أو أنواع الكلمة. The second topic is the fact that أسماء divide into نكرة and معرفة. And the third topic is to discuss the fact that كلمة divides into معرب and مبني. We are in the second part of the third point, where we are going to be discussing now الأحكام الإعرابية. The rules when it comes to إعراب is what we're going to discuss today. We spoke about إعراب is that which can accept change at the ending of the words dependent upon العوامل الداخلة عليها. Right? And we mentioned the example, جاء محمد رأيت محمدا مررت بمحمد. Likewise, we said the مبني is that which cannot accept a change at the end of its word. And we gave the example of هؤلاء. It carries and it maintains that state which is a كسرة upon the ending of that noun. Right? So you say جاء هؤلاء رأيت هؤلاء مررت بهؤلاء. Right? So now we're going to speak about al-ahkam, the rules that a person must have an understanding of in order for him to be able to perform what we call in the English language grammatical analysis. The author, he said, al-ahkam al-irabiyyatu arba'atun. The laws of al-irab, or the types of irab, are four. The letter, or the word I should say, can be either marfu', which is raf', or nasb, which is the second. The third is al-jar. And the fourth is al-jazm. So the ahkam wal-i'rab are these four. So when we deal with the fi'l al-mudari' al-mu'raba, and when we deal with the asma' al-mu'raba, we are going to discuss what? We are going to discuss al-raf' wal-nasb wal-jar wal-jazm. Of course, the jar and the jazm, you'll see that it's specific to the noun. The jar is specific to the noun, and the mudari' is specific to the jazm. The jazm is specific to the mudari'. طيب. So the author, رحمه الله وفقه الله, he mentions, فالأسماء كلها المعربة والمبنية يدخلها الرفع والنصب والجر. When it comes to the nouns, whether it is معرب or whether it is مبني, it will be affected by رفع, نصب, and جر. We will mention these things. When it comes to the معرب and the مبني. When it comes to the معرب, we will say it is مرفوع. When it comes to الأسماء المعربة, we will say it is مرفوع. Or we will say it is mansub. We will say it is majrur. As for the mabni, we will say, i.e. al-asma' al-mabniyah, we will say fi mahalli raf'in. It's in the place of al-raf'. Or fi mahalli nasbin. It is in the place of nasb. And we're going to say also fi mahalli jarrin. It is in the place of jar. And we'll see examples of that later, bi-idhnillah. So these asma', whether it's mu'rab or mabni, it will be analyzed and it will be given this hukum, this ruling. Whether it is raf'a, نصب or جر. And then the author, he gave an example. مثلا محمد يكرم الضيف بحفاوة. محمد, here it is an ism. Why? Because it can accept تنوين. However, in this case, when I said محمد, محمد here is a مبتدا, and the مبتدا is a مرفوع. And so محمد here is in the state of رفع. We say it is what? مرفوع. يكرم is a فعل. Leave that to one side. الضيفة here is a منصوب. Why? Because it's a مفعول به. So it is in the case of النصب. So we give it the second حكم عرابي, which is النصب. محمد, we gave it the first حكم عرابي for the noun, which is الرفع. We gave the second ruling, which was النصب, to الضيفة. بحفاوة, باء here is حرف جر. And so حفاوة here, because it can accept a حرف جر, it's also an ism. Because it's an ism, we say that حفاوة here, it is in the state of جر. And so as you can see in this example, we've gathered together the three types of rulings that asma are affected by. Al-Rafa, wa al-Nasb, wa al-Jar. That is in the case of al-Asma al-Mu'rabah. Muhammadun is Mu'rab, Dayfa is Mu'rab, and Hafawatin is Mu'rab. What about an example for when they are Mabni? Hatha yukrimu sibawayhi billadhi yuhibbu. Hatha is a Mubtala. And it is in the position of a Rafa. It is fi mahalli Rafa'in. And it is مبني. It is مبني على السكون. It is في محل رفع. So as you can see, I'm using the word رفع. It is in the place of a رفع. And it's a اسم. It's اسم مبني. مبني على السكون. Let me يكرم will leave it to one side because it's a فعل. سيبويه. سيبويه, we said the words, the nouns that end in ويه are what? مبنية. We took it in the previous lesson. And so سيبويه here is in the place of نصب, في محل نصب. Why? Because it is in the place of the مفعول به. طيب, so it is in the في محل نصب, and it's in the place of a نصب. And so here we see سيبويه is affected by the term نصب. You are given the حكم العرابي. We said it is in the place of a منصوب or a نصب. بالذي, الذي is also من أسماء الموصولة, so it is مبني, it is مبني, and it's preceded by a باء حرف جر, therefore الذي here is in the place of a جر, في محل جر. And so as you can see, the أسماء, whether they are معربة or مبنية, they are affected by the نصب, the جر, and the رفع. طيب, what about the أفعال المضارعة? The author he said, والأفعال المضارعة كلها المعربة والمبنية يدخلها الرفع والنصب والجزم. Likewise, the مضارع, whether it is معرب or مبني, and we spoke about the types of مضارع that are معرب and the types of مضارع that are مبني. The types of مضارع that are مبني are that which is attached to the end of it a نون النسوة or نون التوكيد. If it's نون التوكيد, then the حرف or the مضارع will be مبني على الفتح. If it's a نون النسوة, then the فعل مضارع will be مبني على السكون. So he says, الأفعال المضارعة, whether they are معربة أو مبنية, they are affected by رفع, نصب, and جزم. So see here, جزم is specific to the فعل المضارع. The جر is specific to the أسماء. طيب, and that's why we mentioned in the signs of the أسماء is what? That it can accept حرف جر. A فعل مضارع can accept حرف جر. طيب, so that's why حرف جر is a sign for a noun. طيب, so the أفعال المضارعة كلها المعربة والمبنية يدخلها الرفع والنصب والجزم. Then he gave examples of the أفعال المضارعة المعربة when they are in the case of رفع نصب and جر, and then he gave an example for when they are مبني in the state of في محل رفع, في محل نصب, في محل جزم. He says أجتهدوا. أجتهدوا is a فعل مضارع مرفوع. It's the أصل. It's built upon الرفع. أجتهدوا. ولم أهمل. ولم أهمل. أهمل هي it is فعل مضارع. However, it is مجزوم. It is has the state of جزم. Why? Because it's preceded by a أداة من أدوات الجزم, a tool from the tools of الجزم, which is in this case لم. ولن أهملا. أهملا هي it is in the مرفوع, it is in the منصوب case. Why is it in the منصوب case? Because it's preceded by a حرف نصب. It is preceded by a particle of نصب, which is in this case لن. So as you can see, أجتهد, أهمل, أهمل, in these two scenarios, in these three cases, they have been affected by the الحكم العرابي. The أجتهد is مرفوع. The first أهمل is مجزوم, and the second أهمل is منصوب. Then he gave example of the مبني, which is الطالبات يجتهدن ولم يهملن ولن يهملن. So يجتهدن here, it is in the محل رفع. It is in the محل of الرفع, because it is مبني. مبني على السكون في محل رفع. ولم يهملن, this of course نون النسوة. طيب, so it's مبني على السكون. ولم يهملن, لم here is what? لم it is a أداة من أدوات الجزم. Therefore, يهملنا is في محل جزم. It is in the place of a مجزوم. It is in the place of a جزم. And it's مبني على السكون. ولن يهملنا. Likewise, here يهملنا in this scenario, it is in the فعل المضارع. يهمل here is in the منصوب case. It is في محل نصب. Why is it في محل نصب? It is because it's preceded by a لن. It is preceded by لن. Therefore, we say that لن يهملنا. يهملنا here is in the case of what? It is in the case of في محل نصب. And of course, مبني على السكون. طيب, that is the أفعال المضارعة, both the معرب and the مبني. يدخلها الرفع والنصب والجزم. As for the أسماء, whether it's معرب or مبني, يدخلها الرفع والنصب والجر. As for the حروف and the فعل الماضي and the فعل الأمر, لا يدخلها حكم إعرابي. No إعرابي ruling. None of the رفع or the نصب or the جر or the جزم can enter upon a حرف or a فعل ماضي or a فعل أمر. So the حروف, فعل أمر, فعل ماضي cannot accept any form of grammatical analysis by way of these four points that I mentioned, these four rulings, i.e. the رفع, the نصب, the جر, and the جزم. Now the author, وفقه الله, he now goes on to tell us the gateway or the methodology that a person is to apply in performing grammatical analysis. What are the steps that I have to take in order for me to be able to become proficient in grammatically analyzing words and sentences? So the author, he said, take a imaginary line. خط, take an imaginary line. Have on one side the مبني, i.e. the حروف and the أفعال الماضية that are not grammatically analyzed with the رفع, نصب, جر, and جزم. And then on another side of this imaginary line, deal with the types of words and as we will see inshallah ta'ala, that can be affected by the raf' al-nasb, jar and jazm. So he's given us a imaginary line. We have on one side of the imaginary line how we deal with the i'rab of the huruf, the fi'il madhi and the fi'il amr. And then on the other side of the line, we're going to have a step-by-step process in how to perform i'rab of the types of words, i.e. the nouns and the af'al al-mudari'ah, whether they are mu'rab or mabni, how we tackle them, how we deal with them. So let's begin with the first side of this imaginary line. He says, تقع خط الإعراب تقع قبله الكلمات التي لا تدخلها الأحكام العربية. So remember, as I said, take this imaginary line. Before this imaginary line, right, have your rulings, or the step-by-step process you're going to take in performing the إعراب of those words that do not have a حكم إعرابي. They are not affected by رفع نصب جر and جزم. And we mentioned them to be the حروف and the أفعال الماضي and the أفعال الأمر. He says, عليه رحمة الله وفقه الله, he says, ولإعرابها ثلاثة أركان. Or before that he says, وهي الحروف والأفعال الماضية وأفعال الأمر. We mentioned this. ويقال في إعرابها لا محل له من الإعراب. Memorize this sentence, memorize this point. Whenever you're going to analyze a fi'il ماضي or a harf or a fi'il amr, you are going to always use this term, لا محل له من الإعراب. It has no place when it comes to إعراب, because it's not affected by the حكم العرابي. The حكم العرابي, أحكام العرابي are four, رفع, نصب, جر, and جزم. The أفعال الماضية, the حروف, and the أفعال الأمر, they are not affected by these أحكام. Therefore, you say, لا محل له أو لا محل لها من الإعراب. This is a key sentence for you to have an understanding of when it comes to the grammatical analysis of these أفعال الماضية, أفعال الأمر, and these أحرف, or these حروف. When you want to perform a grammatical analysis of these types, i.e. the fi'il madhi, the fi'il amr, and the huruf, you need to know three things. You need to know three things. The first thing is, نوعها. You have to make clarification of the type of word it is. Is it a harf? If it's a harf, what type of harf is it? Is it a fi'il madhi or is it a fi'il amr? You have to clarify that. The second is, you have to clarify the haraka of its bina, i.e. the ending of this word. What is the haraka upon it? What is it mabni upon? Is it mabni ala sukun? Is it mabni ala al-fath? طيب, and so on. The third is, hukmuha al-i'rabi. You have to also clarify its grammatical ruling. And the grammatical ruling is what I mentioned. La mahalla lahu min al-i'rab. La mahalla lahu min al-i'rab. That is the grammatical ruling when it comes to the af'al al-madhiyah, af'al al-amr, and the huruf. So let's give examples. The author, وفقه الله, he gave an example. He said, هل ذهب, and then اذهب. So هل here, it is a harf. هل here is a harf. Remember, we gave the signs. We mentioned the signs of the harf. We mentioned the signs of the asma and the signs of the af'al. If you don't know it, go and learn it. We know that the signs of the harf are, i.e., those words that cannot accept the signs of the asma and the signs of the af'al. If these words cannot accept any sign of the asma or any sign of the af'al, they are automatically a harf. Hal, what kind of harf is hal? Hal is what we call a question, harf istifham. It's an interrogative particle. Harf istifham is a question. Hal is, طيب, the equivalent in the English language. So it's a harf istifham. So we've answered the first point in the Arab, which is bayan nu'iha. What type of word is it? If it's a harf, what type of harf is it? It is a harf istifham. Then it is mabni. The second point I have to comply with is bayan harakati bina'iha. It is mabni. Mabni upon what? We say it is mabni ala sukun. The lam here has a sukun on it. Hal. Therefore, we say it is harfu istifhamin. Mabni ala sukun. And then we say our cardinal point, which was la mahalla lahu min al-i'rab. La mahalla lahu min al-i'rab. Then we have dhahaba. Dhahaba here, it is fi'lu madhin. It is a past tense. Hal dhahaba? Went. Did he? Or, yani in this case, hal mean did. Did he go? Did he go? ذهب. ذهب here is فعل ماضي. فعل ماضي, we said it's always مبني. مبني upon what? We look at the ending of the word. It is in this case a باء with a فتح on it. So we say it's مبني على الفتح. مبني على الفتح. Then we say the cardinal point. لا محل له من الإعراب. And then with this, as you can see, we've come with the three points that I'm supposed to come with when the إعراب of these types of words. The next word that he says is اذهب. اذهب is فعل أمر. Go. طيب, اذهب is فعل أمر. اذهب here, it's مبني. مبني upon what? مبني على السكون. اذهب. مبني على السكون. And then we say the cardinal point again. لا محل له من الإعراب. If you are able to take these three arkan, these three pillars, which is بيان النوع, ثم بيان حركة البناء, ثم بيان حكمها العراب, which is always going to be لا محل له من العراب, then you are going to be sound when it comes to performing grammatical analysis of the أحرف or the حروف, likewise the الأفعال الماضية and the أفعال الأمر. Now we go on to the next part, which is, you see this imaginary line, you've taken what's before it, now you're going to take what comes after it. What comes after this imaginary line is الكلمات التي تدخلها الأحكام العرابية, those words that the four rulings of عراب enter upon, which is the رفع, the نصب, the جر, and the جزم. So the author, وفقه الله, he mentions them that they are the أسماء and the أفعال المضارعة. And then he says again, the إعراب of the أسماء and the أفعال المضارعة learn three pillars. They are built upon three pillars. Number one, بيان نوع المضارع وبيان موقع الاسم من الجملة. What this means is, what type of مضارع is it? Is it a مضارع which is going to be معرب, or is it a مضارع which is going to be مبني? You have to be able to clarify this. Likewise, the اسم, the noun, where has it occurred in the sentence? Is it a فاعل? Is it a مفعول به? And so on. So that's the first point. The second point is بيان الحكم العرابي وبيان الحركة. You have to also clarify the specific ruling of العراب which applies to this word. Is it مرفوع? Is it منصوب? Is it مجزوم? Is it مجرور? Likewise the حركة. Likewise the حركة. Is it مرفوع? What is the sign of الرفع here? مثلا, is it مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة? Or is it مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الواو نيابة عن الضمة مثلا؟ Or is it منصوب وعلامة نصبه الفتحة, منصوب وعلامة نصبه الياء, which is what? In replacement of the فتحة مثلا. Is it مجرور? What is the sign of الجر? We know that the classical sign for الجر is the كسرة, but sometimes there could be something that we call نيابة, replacement for the كسرة, like the ياء مثلا. طيب, and so you have to clarify, what is the حكم العرابي and what is the حركة that shows this sign of الإعراب? For example, الجزم, what is the sign? Is it a سكون or is it حذف حرف أو حذف آخره أو حذف حرف العلة? Which one is it? طيب, you have to clarify what the type of إعراب is or what the type of إعراب it is, and likewise the حركة that shows that إعراب. The sign of that إعراب is the حركة الضمة مثلا if it's مرفوع, and so on. And then the author, رحمه الله, he gives examples of what we have mentioned. طيب, one more point, and we've mentioned this point previously, when it comes to the مبني, we don't say مرفوع, منصوب, مجذور, rather we say في محل رفع, in the place of a رفع, or in the place of a نصب, or in the place of a جر, i.e. this part, this مبني word has come in a place where usually a مرفوع is found, or where usually a منصوب is found. So it's in lieu of, in place of a رفع, في محل رفع, it's in the place of a رفع. طيب, let's now take examples. The author, وفقه الله, he said, ينصر محمد الحق. ينصر محمد الحق. ينصر, here it is a فعل مضارع. So let's apply the three pillars. Number one, بيان نوع المضارع. Number one, it is a فعل مضارع. ينصر here is a فعل مضارع. And it is معرب. ينصر is a فعل مضارع. How do we know it's معرب? Then we come to the two points that we mentioned, the two remaining points, which is بيان حكم العرب وحركتها. So here we say that ينصر is فعل مضارع مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة الظاهرة. So we say it's فعل مضارع number one, مرفوع number two, وعلامة رفعه الضمة الظاهرة, an explicit ضمة. محمد, محمد here is an اسم, but what type of اسم is it? Where has it occurred in the sentence? It occurs in the sentence as a فاعل, as the subject. And so we say محمد here is a فاعل, and the فاعل is always مرفوع وعلامة رفعه, the sign of رفع here is what? الضمة. ينصر محمد دون. You see, it is a مرفوع and the sign of رفع is a ضمة. الحق, الحق here is also an اسم. Remember, you see, you can accept the ال. حق is truth. الحق is the truth. So we see حق is an اسم. So الحق here, it is a مفعول به. It is an اسم that has occurred in the sentence as an object, as a مفعول به. طيب, and the مفعول به is always منصوب. We will see why the فاعل is مرفوع and why the مفعول به is منصوب later. طيب, but for now we're just trying to apply these cardinal principles for performing إعراب of these كلمات that are what? That can accept the حكم العرابي. So we say that الحق here is a مفعول به منصوب وعلامة نصبه الفتحة. الحق, الحق, the علامة of النصب is الفتحة. طيب, Then he gives an example for the mabni, for the asma that are mabniya, and he says ha'ula'i yukrimna hadha. Ha'ula'i here, it is a mubtada. Ha'ula'i here is a mubtada. And so mubtada, the asl is that it is what marfu'. And so ha'ula'i, it is in the place of a raf'. It is fi mahalli raf'in. And then we say, what is it mabni upon? It is mabni ala al-kasr. It is mabni ala al-kasr. Ha'ula'i. So that's the i'rab for ha'ula'i. We say it is mubtada fi mahalli raf'in mabni ala al-kasri. Or you can say mubtada mabni ala al-kasr fi mahalli raf'in. You can bring it back and forth. You can يعني, put one ahead of the other. No problem in that. Yukrimna. Yukrim is the fi'il mudari'. It is a fi'il mudari'. However, this fi'il mudari', it is mabni. Why? Because it's attached to, at the end of it, a nunu niswa. And remember, we said the nunu niswa, if it attaches onto the fi'il mudari' transfers from being mu'rab to mabni, and it becomes mabni ala as-sukun. And so we say, ha'ula'i yukrimna. Yukrim here is fi'il mudari'. However, it is mabni ala as-sukun. Why is mabni ala as-sukun? Litisalihi bi nun al-niswa. Litisalihi bi nun al-niswa, the feminine nun. And so we say that it is فعل مضارع في محل رفع مبني على السكون أو فعل مضارع مبني على السكون في محل رفع. Or we can say فعل مضارع مبني على السكون لاتصاله بنون النسوة في محل رفع. The فعل مضارع, the أصل is that it is what? مرفوع. In this scenario it is in the state of, or is in the position of a رفع. And so that's why we say في محل رفع. And it is of course مبني على السكون. Why is it مبني على السكون? Due to it being attached, or the end of it being attached with a نون النسوة. نون النسوة. We have to also make grammatical analysis of the نون النسوة. نون النسوة here, it is a فاعل. It's a noun. نون النسوة is a noun. It's a ضمير. And this ضمير, نون النسوة, is a فاعل. It occurs in the sentence as a فاعل, the subject. This is the one doing the act of doing the act of ikram, doing the act of honoring. طيب. And so we say nun al-niswa here is a fa'il. It's a fa'il. The asr of the fa'il is that it is what? Marfu'. And so we say this nun al-niswa is fi mahalli raf'in. It is in the place of a raf', i.e. the fa'il, which is a asalatan marfu'. This nun al-niswa, which is mabni, has occurred in the case of a raf'. And then we say, of course, we look at the haraka upon the nun, which is of course a fatha. So we say it is mabni ala الفتح, مبني على الفتح. Then we have the last point, which is هذا. هذا here is the object, so it's مفعول به. And مفعول به أصالة, it is what? منصوب. And so we say هذا, because it's مبني, we say it's في محل نصب. في محل نصب. And then we say what we look at, هذا, the ending of the word هذا is an ألف. The ألف has a سكون on it. And so we say it is مبني على السكون. And so we say هذا is مفعول به, مبني على السكون في محل نصب. So these are the three pillars that you need in order for you to be able to competently make grammatical analysis of the words. These are the three steps. Number one, بيان النوع أو بيان موقع الاسم في الجملة. طيب, that's the first point. Then the second point is بيان حكم الإعراب. And then the third point is بيان حركة الإعراب. طيب, if you come with these three points and you follow it in that order, then you will be a competent person with the ability, or you will have the ability to conduct أحكام or conduct analysis, grammatical analysis. Of course, there are some rules and principles we have to learn in order for us to be able to competently perform grammatical analysis, which we'll take later bi-ibnillahi ta'ala as we go along. However, these are the three principles we have to have in our head, that when I am trying to perform grammatical analysis, I need to satisfy these three points. Number one, bayan al-naw', to clarify the type of word it is, and the type of word it is, whether it's mu'rab or mabni, whether it's a harf or a fi'il, or a fi'il madhi, or fi'il mudari', or fi'il amr. Likewise, I have to have an understanding of the حكم الإعراب. What is the ruling? What kind of إعراب ruling does it take? طيب, is it a harf where there is لا محل له من الإعراب, or is it something like an ism, or is it something like a فعل مضارع which doesn't have a نون النسوة attached to it, or something like that, or does it have a نون التوكير attached to it, or نون النسوة attached to it? And if that is the case, I have to clarify that, I have to mention that. And then I have to also mention حركة الإعراب. What is the حركة? What is the حركة that this إعراب, that is the sign for this إعراب? It is مرفوع. What is the sign of this رفع? Is it ضمة? Is it واو? Is it ألف? And so on. طيب, so we have to talk about that in detail. Of course, the signs of al-i'rab in terms of the harakat of al-i'rab, we'll talk about that later in detail bin Allah ta'ala. But for now, it's these three pillars which you have to have an understanding of, which is being able to clarify the type, being able to give the hukm al-i'rabi, and being able to mention the harakat al-i'rab. And we've spoken about the asma' al-mu'raba and the mabniya have, and of course the fi'l mudari' al-mabniya al-mu'raba, all deal with the four types of rulings when it comes to al-i'rab, al-raf' wal-nasb wal-jar wal-jazm. We said jar is specific to the asma, and the jazm is specific to the af'al. And we said the ahruf or the huruf and the af'al al-madi and the af'al al-amr, they have no analysis. لا محل لهم من الإعراب. They have no place when it comes to grammatical analysis, meaning they are not affected in any way, shape or form by the رفع, the نصب, the جر and the جزم. And so مثلا in the example that we gave previously, we said هل ذهب. So we said that هل here is what? حرف استفهام. That's the first point, بيان النوع. Then we said that is مبني على السكون. This is بيان حركة البناء. And then we said لا محل له من الإعراب, بيان الحكم الإعرابي. And so now we'll stop here بإذن الله. We'll continue with the ending of this third part of the first section, which is talking about the fact that the أسماء divide into مبني and معرب. We will discuss علامات الإعراب in the next lesson. So we will stop here بإذن الله. والله تعالى أعلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.